The technique showed in this video is an example. Please consult instructions for use before using this product. The Broncoflex is available in two sizes that are color-coded: gray for Broncoflex Agile and orange for Broncoflex Vortex. There are no protective covers or accessories that need to be removed. Before using the product, control checks on bending, suction, and image display must be performed. Tracheostomy can be considered in patients with acute respiratory failure who require prolonged mechanical ventilation. The percutaneous technique can be performed quickly and safely at the patient's bedside. Bronchoscopic guidance is strongly recommended during this procedure to reduce the likelihood of paratracheal insertion and to determine the intratracheal position of the needle, wire guide, dilatators, and tracheostomy tube. The Broncoflex is introduced through the patient's endotracheal tube and maintained in the trachea for continuous visualization of the procedure. Landmarks are palpated to a certain proper location for tracheostomy tube placement, and local anesthesia is introduced before a skin incision is made at the chosen site. The endotracheal tube cuff is deflated, placed above the insertion site but within the trachea, and reinflated. A syringe half-filled with fluid and attached to the introducer needle is introduced into the trachea and under bronchoscopic control. The outer FEP sheath of the introducer is advanced while the needle is removed. The J-tipped wire guide is introduced into the trachea and visualized while advancing distally toward the carina. The introducer is removed while maintaining the wire guide position within the tracheal lumen. The short introducer dilator is advanced and then removed over the wire guide. The blue Rhino multi-G2 dilator is immersed in water and advanced over the wire guide with its guiding catheter as a unit. The dilating assembly is advanced and pulled back several times to effectively dilate the tracheal access site. Bronchoscopic guidance may prevent possible trauma to the posterior tracheal wall. The dilator is removed while keeping the wire guide and guiding catheter in place. Then the tracheostomy tube is introduced with its loading dilator to its flange. The guiding catheter, dilator, and wire guide are removed, leaving the tracheostomy tube in place. The Broncoflex is inserted into the tracheostomy tube to confirm correct placement. The tracheostomy tube cuff is inflated, the tube connected to the ventilator. Endotracheal tube is deflated and removed. Suction is used to exclude significant bleeding or obstruction.